Okay. Dear students, a warm welcome to you as we begin today's class with this subtopic. We are still on volcanicity, and we want to begin today's class. We are beginning today's class with this subtopic on volcanicity. And the subtopic is materials ejected during volcanic eruption. So having defined volcanicity as a process through which the molten rock or magma are emitted during volcanic eruption, the emission may get to the surface or the materials may stop before getting to the surface. Now, for today, our focus is materials ejected during volcanic eruption. So many materials are thrown up by volcano during volcanic eruption. And during volcanic eruption, the materials that are ejected from deep below, the materials that are ejected from the interior of the earth, they include the following. So one of the materials ejected or emitted into the atmosphere during volcanic eruption includes, one, gases. We also have steam. Lava is also emitted into the atmosphere. We also have rock pieces, and we have what is called dust. So what are these gases that are emitted or released into the atmosphere during volcanic eruption? The most important of these gases is carbon dioxide. So during volcanic eruption, carbon dioxide is released into the atmosphere. Another material that is released into the atmosphere during volcanic eruption is what is called steam. Of course, what brought about steam in the interior of the earth? You know, in our last lesson, I mentioned the fact that the interior of the earth, the temperature in the interior of the earth is quite high. What is the implication of that? The implication of that is that all the available water around that volcanic rock will turn to either vapor or steam. And this is what is exactly emitted during eruption. So, the water available in the volcanic rock turns to vapor or steam. The water around the volcanic mountain, during volcanic eruption, such water turns to vapor or steam. And that is what is emitted during volcanic eruption. Another material that is emitted during volcanic eruption is what is called lava. Another name for lava is magma or molten rock. You know, I mentioned during our last lesson that all the rocks in the interior of the earth, they become so superheated as a result of the prevailing high temperature in the interior of the earth. It makes such rock to get so superheated to the extent that it turns to semi-liquid. So during volcanic eruption, what is emitted into the atmosphere is what is called liquefied rock. Liquefied rock, or it is also called lava, L-A-V-A. The last but not the least of the materials ejected into the atmosphere during volcanic eruption, they are categorized as non-lava materials. They are categorized as non-lava materials. So what are these non-lava materials that are emitted into the atmosphere during volcanic eruption? They include rock pieces and dust. Can we give examples of such rock pieces and dust? Examples of rock pieces include something that is called volcanic bombs. They are large stones. Large stones are thrown up violently into the atmosphere during volcanic eruption, and they sound much like bombs. And that is why it is called volcanic bombs. They are large stones. When they are emitted or thrown into the atmosphere during volcanic eruption, they sound much like bombs. So they are called volcanic bombs. Then you also have another one that is in that category, and that is what is called volcanic ash. Volcanic ash, they are the dust. That is the dust component of the non-lava material. They are the dust that are emitted into the atmosphere during volcanic eruption. So rock pieces and dust, they are all categorized as non-lava materials. So I want to move on to, how many minutes we have? Four. So I want to move on to another. Now, we want to continue from where we stopped. And actually, we were mentioning the materials that are ejected onto the Earth's surface during volcanic eruption. And from there, we want to quickly move to examples of eruptions that are taking place from time immemorial. And we are starting on an interesting note by mentioning the most memorable eruption. And of course, that is the most important eruption that had ever taken place in the world. And this eruption actually occurred around a mountain called Mountain Krakatoa. This mountain is actually found on an island, an Indian Ocean island. And on this fateful day, exactly on Monday, 27th of August, 1883, the greatest explosion in history occurred around Mountain Krakatoa. And this explosion, volcanic eruption, affected about two-thirds of the whole of the island. And what happened to this island? The explosion brought down and reduced two-thirds of this island to ashes. The explosion was so loud that it was heard in Australia. And Australia to this place is about 4,800 kilometers away. So that is to tell us the magnitude of the explosion, of the eruption of Mountain Krakatoa, an Indian Ocean island. The explosion was so tragic to the extent that almost 36,000 people were drowned. Of course, it's an island, so almost 36,000 people were drowned during that volcanic eruption of Mountain Krakatoa. Another eruption took place On June 12, 1991, in faraway Philippines. And the explosion occurred, or the eruption, Mountain Pinatubo is in Philippines. So Mountain Pinatubo in Philippines experienced explosion on June 12, 1991. And what transpired during this explosion was also emission of even earthquakes, and it also resulted in very heavy rainfall, torrential rainfall. So it isn't the explosion alone that occurred. It also experienced earthquakes and torrential rainfall. And this results, the explosion actually caused destruction of about 200,000 houses. So these are the examples of eruptions that are taking place from time immemorial. Then finally, we now want to move to types of volcano. Types of volcanoes. There are three types of volcanoes. We have active volcanoes, we have dormant volcanoes, and we have extinct volcanoes. What are extinct volcanoes? Extinct volcanoes, they refer to those volcanic rocks or volcanic mountains that have not erupted for more than 2,000 years. So they have not erupted, no history of eruption of such mountain for 2 or 3,000 years. An example of this mountain is our own Jos Plateau. So an example of extinct volcano is our own Jos Plateau in Nigeria. It doesn't have any history of eruption. Another type of volcano is what is called dormant volcanoes. All the volcanic mountains in this category, they have erupted, or they suddenly erupt after a very long period of dormancy. They seem not to erupt again, but suddenly they will just erupt. And that is exactly what happened to Mountain Pinatubo in Philippines. Mountain Pinatubo erupted in 1991 after about 600 years of dormancy. And the last but not the least is the active volcanoes. All the volcanic mountains in this category, they erupt regularly. Example of such volcanic mountain is Mountain Cameroon in our own continent of Africa.